It's time for baseball's annual midsummer celebration as the All-Stars have gathered in the heart and heat of Texas.
It's still one of the greatest experiences a major leaguer can have.
Man, this is great. This is great.
It's the future right here.
This is my 14th All-Star game, and I wouldn't want to miss this for the world.
Label the media this year heavily international.
Y después de la pausa, regresaremos al estadio de Arlington en Dallas, Texas.
Here's the mall boy and All-Star Spiel. What's this been doing?
Yo, this is the biggest party in baseball here at the All-Star game.
Dodger rookie sensation Hideo Nomo and Seattle's 6'10 intimidator Randy Johnson are the starting pitchers.
I think that's the matchup everybody wants to see.
If I can face Randy Johnson, I can face Nomo.
Hey, the show has just begun. Let's celebrate. The 66th All-Star Game is next.
It began as a one-shot deal in 1933 in Chicago, and here it is, 1995, the 66th Major League Baseball All-Star Game. And for the first time ever, it comes to North Texas, home of the Texas Rangers since 1972, and to the ballpark in Arlington, a beautiful new facility in its second year. Capacity crowd of close to 50,000 to look on. The ballpark in Arlington, hosting the All-Star Game. I'm Al Michaels, and welcome to Arlington. And there is really no need to rehash what this sport has been through over the past year. It has been terrible. But the people who play the game and the people who run the game want to put everything on the back burner. They know the problems persist, but at least for one night, just concentrate on baseball as the brightest stars in both leagues have gathered in one ballpark for the annual midsummer celebration. They call it an All-Star Game, but it's really an individual showcase, because when you think about the memories, they deal with individuals. In 1934, Carl Hubbell struck out 5 future Hall of Famers in succession. In 1970, Pete Rose barreled over Ray Fosse for the winning run. In 71, Reggie Jackson hits an otherworldly home run onto the roof in Detroit. In 84, a 19-year-old rookie by the name of Dwight Gooden strikes out the side. So when this crowd goes home, long after they have forgotten who wins or loses, they'll remember some individual feat. And Tim McCarver, the way the ball travels in this ballpark, it might be a 500-foot home run.
Well, it's possible. As a matter of fact, that's what people look for when they think of the All-Star Game. They think of the mashers, the bashers, the guys that knock the ball out of the ballpark. That's why they had a home run hitting contest yesterday. But think of this. In All-Star history, the collective batting average of all the hitters, and that means all of them, Williams, Musial, Aaron, Mays, is 245. A meager 245. So we should turn our attention to the pitchers, and that's exactly what we're doing tonight. Hideo Nomo, the sensational Japanese rookie, and the terrifying Randy Johnson, and I mean he is something.
On the subject of pitching, our Hall of Famer Jim Palmer is here, and Jim, of all of the improbable scenarios one could have thought up in March or April, it would be Hideo Nomo starting the All-Star Game.
Well, you're certainly right, Al. I mean, they sign him, and I think it's very skeptically, it's just a publicity stunt by the Dodgers, a couple of million dollars. But for years they've been saying, as a matter of fact, eons, they've been saying, well, Japanese, they're inferior to the Americans because the Americans are bigger, faster, stronger. And here comes this kid. He dominates the National League. 12 strikeouts per 9 innings, least amount of hits per 9 innings, the lowest batting average against. But this is not about starting the National League and doing a good job. It's starting the National League All-Star and for the North All-Stars. And the bottom line is that he is pitching for the nation of Japan.
Well, they're all here. Barry Bonds and Frank Thomas and all of the rest. The All-Star Game coming up when we return after this from our ABC stations.
Has a
Hi, Drew Carey here with All-Star Game Trivia. You know, there's been 9 extra inning games in the history of the All-Star Game, and the National League has won all of them. You know how? They cheat. That's right, Piazza. I got my eye on you. You too, Nomo. I don't know what you're doing, but cut it out. Hey, guess what side I'm rooting for?
The Drew Carey Show, coming Wednesdays this fall on ABC.
Okay, watch closely. This is the new DQ Treats a Pizza, but it's not a hot eat. It's a cool treat, a treat you eat like pizza. There's fudge, chocolate crunch, soft serve, and your choice of 4 different combinations of toppings, all for just $4.99. New frozen DQ Treats a Pizza, the only pizza that tastes better cold.
Hot eats, cool treats, we treat you right.
McAlpin's will close Tuesday at 5:30 p.m. to take inventory and mark down prices. We reopen Wednesday at 11 a.m. for McAlpin's biggest store-wide after inventory sales. Don't miss it.
Distinctive, durable, attention to detail, all trademarks of Toomey Luggage. Toomey meets the needs of today's traveler. Leather Incorporated at Lexington Green.
They say the less they dress, the better.
Look at me. Look at my screen. Look at my legs.
Next step.
Apollo 13 movie, American Heroes, and we're bringing them back.
Hello, hearties. We are hungry. Over.
Roger. Apollo, recommend 3 Apollo combos. Over.
Roger.
2 juicy beef patties, cheese, and special sauce with booster-sized fries and Coke, just $2.99. Hearties Apollo combo.
We are go for lunch.
The biggest combo for the money on the planet.
Think they'll be back?
The taste always brings them back.
Fresh from the kitchen at Hardee's, over.
Collect all 20 Apollo 13 Pog Milk Caps and Moon Slammer, just 99 cents with any Hardee's combo.
Sports with Kenny Rice, tonight at 11.
1995 All-Star Game, brought to you by the Snake Light Flexible Flashlight. Another great gift idea from Black & Decker. And Goodyear, number one in tires.
From the great Lone Star State, we welcome you to the ballpark in Arlington and baseball's 66th All-Star Game. Let's meet the trainers, coaches, and all-stars from the National League. The trainers from the Florida Marlins, Larry Starr. And from the Montreal Expos, Mike Kozak. The batting practice staff from the Montreal Expos, Jerry Manuel, Tommy Harper, and Joe Kerrigan. The coaches from the Chicago Cubs, Jim Riggleman. And from the Houston Astros, Terry Collins. And now, the National League All-Star Team. From the Atlanta Braves, selected but unable to play due to injury, pitcher Greg Maddux. From the Chicago Cubs, first baseman Mark Grace. Outfielder Sammy Sosa. And pitcher Randy Myers. From the Cincinnati Reds, outfielder Reggie Sanders. And pitcher John Smiley. From the Colorado Rockies, outfielder Dante Bichette. From the Florida Marlins, outfielder Jeff Conine. From the Los Angeles Dodgers, shortstop Jose Offerman. Pitcher Todd Worrell. And outfielder Raul Mondesi. From the Montreal Expos, pitcher Carlos Perez. From the New York Mets, infielder Bobby Bonilla. From the Philadelphia Phillies, catcher Darren Dalton. Second baseman Mickey Morandini. Pitcher Tyler Green. And pitcher Heathcliff Slocum. From the Pittsburgh Pirates, pitcher Denny Nagel. From the St. Louis Cardinals, elected but unable to play due to injury, shortstop Ozzie Smith. pitcher Tom Hickey. From the San Francisco Giants, elected but unable to play due to injury, third baseman Matt Williams. And now, tonight's starting lineup for the National League. First, the manager of the National League, from the Montreal Expos, Felipe Alou. Leading off, from the Philadelphia Phillies, center fielder, Lenny Dykstra. Batting second, from the San Diego Padres, right fielder, Tony Gwynn. Batting third, from the San Francisco Giants, left fielder, Barry Bonds. Batting fourth, from the Los Angeles Dodgers, catcher, Mike Piazza. From the Atlanta Braves, first baseman Fred McGriff. Batting sixth from the Cincinnati Reds, designated hitter Ron Gant. Batting seventh from the Cincinnati Reds, shortstop Barry Larkin. Batting eighth from the Colorado Rockies, third baseman Benny Castilla. Batting ninth from the Houston Astros, second baseman Craig Biggio. And the starting pitcher from the Los Angeles Dodgers, Hideo Nomo. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1995 National League All-Stars.
That's the National League, the American League lineups and reserves when we come back.
Here at Goodyear's biggest tire plant, we're gearing up for the tire sale you've been waiting for. It's our 25% off sale. Save 25% on selected Goodyear tires at participating retailers all across America. But hurry, this sale ends July 22nd.
Oh, well, I'm the kind of light that likes to bend around. You can point me left or right or hang me upside down. But I'm not the kind of light you have to hang on to. Just use me when you need three hands, but you've got cause I'm the snake light. They call me the snake light.
It's the totally flexible hands-free flashlight from Black & Decker.
Yeah, we're the snake lights from Black & Decker. We get around, 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 around.
Imagine a satellite system that received transmissions from 22,000 miles in space. Imagine if it turned digital signals into vivid pictures and CD quality sound. What would it look like? How big would it be? About 18 inches. The RCA Digital Satellite System. Customized programming and the power of digital technology. Now in a convenient take-home size.
Get the DSS system with no payments or interest till January 96. See your RCA dealer.
The customized 1947 Harley Davidson, about $15,000. The Bic Twin Shaver, about 35 cents. What do they have in common? They're both worth every penny.
Let's meet the trainers, coaches, and all-stars from the American League. The trainers from the Seattle Mariners, Rick Griffin. And from the Texas Rangers, Danny Wheat. The batting practice staff from the New York Yankees, Willie Randolph. In the bullpen, Billy Connors. Tony Cloninger and Brian Butterfield.
What up?
The coaches from the Milwaukee Brewers, Phil Garner. And from the Texas Rangers, Johnny Oates. And now, the American League All-Star Team. From the Boston Red Sox, pitcher Eric Hanson. And first baseman, Mo Vaughn. From the California Angels, outfielder Jim Edmonds. Pitcher Chuck Finley. Infielder Gary DeSarcina. And pitcher Lee Smith. From the Cleveland Indians, outfielder Manny Ramirez. Pitcher Dennis Martinez. And pitcher Jose Mesa. From the Detroit Tigers, pitcher David Wells. From the Kansas City Royals, pitcher Kevin Apier. From the Milwaukee Brewers, infielder Kevin Seitzer. From the New York Yankees, catcher Mike Stanley. And outfielder Paul O'Neill. From the Oakland Athletics, pitcher Steve Ontiveros. From the Seattle Mariners, infielder Tino Martinez. Also elected but unable to play due to injury, outfielder Ken Griffey Jr. From the Texas Rangers, pitcher Kenny Rogers. And from the Toronto Blue Jays, infielder Roberto Alomar. And now, tonight's starting lineup for the American League. First, the manager of the American League from the New York Yankees, Buck Showalter. Leading off from the Cleveland Indians, center fielder Kenny Lofton. Batting second from the Cleveland Indians, second baseman Carlos Baerga. Batting third from the Seattle Mariners, designated hitter Edgar Martinez. Batting fourth from the Chicago White Sox, first baseman Frank Thomas. Batting fifth from the Cleveland Indians, left fielder Albert Bell. Batting sixth from the Baltimore Orioles, shortstop Cal Ripken Jr. Batting seventh from the New York Yankees, third baseman Wade Boggs. Batting eighth from the Minnesota Twins, right fielder Kirby Puckett. Batting ninth from the Texas Rangers, catcher Ivan Rodriguez. And warming in the bullpen, the starting pitcher from the Seattle Mariners, Randy Johnson. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1995 American League All-Stars.
It's 7:20 p.m. in Arlington. The temperature 101 degrees. The national anthems when we come back.
Where I come from, there are still people who clean their teeth with salt, sand, and even twigs. Nylon was invented by DuPont. Most people associate nylon with stockings or hose. But the first commercial use was the toothbrush. Tynex is a type of nylon, nylon 612. It touches the lives of nearly 2 billion people every day. My job makes me feel really good to have the toothbrush land in the hands of people who need it.
It's a breakthrough that brings us to a new level of performance. In the rain, in the snow, it even saves gas. Michelin's new energy tires with radial XSE technology. It's science that goes beyond magic.
The classic Airstream, around $5,000. The classic BIC, around 19 cents. What do they have in common? They're both worth every penny.
When you walk in, you know that you're going to get something different.
People that are working there are also very helpful.
Like a little kid in a candy store, they have a little bit of everything.
I've been shopping Pier 1 before shopping Pier 1 was cool.
They've changed. They're more contemporary.
I don't cook, but I do set a cute table, so I get all my dishes and napkins at Pier 1.
I like picture frames. They come in different colors, and I'm into that.
There's probably something for every room of my house.
If you want something to stand out, shop at Pier 1.
Don't miss Pier 1's hot clearance sale going on now.
The Senior Tour's biggest stars meet in Michigan, hoping to drive away with one of their premier events. Coverage of the Ford Senior Players Championship begins Saturday on ABC Sports.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please rise for the singing of O Canada by Canada's Queen of Country Music, Michelle Wright.
Our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Stand on guard for thee.
And now, to honor America, please join 1995 Grammy Award winner and Texas native Lyle Lovett as he sings our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? for the land of the free and the home of the brave.
It's almost game time, and we'll get it going from the ballpark in Arlington, Texas, when we come back for the All-Star Game.
The 1995 All-Star Game, brought to you by Bic Products. Bic, worth every penny. And Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires. We'll be back with the start of the All-Star Game after this ABC News brief and a word from our ABC stations.
An ABC News brief. Now from Washington, John Cochran.
Good evening. President Clinton today defended his decision to normalize relations with Vietnam, saying the U.S. will have a better chance of accounting for soldiers missing from the war. Srebrenica became the first U.N. safe haven to fall to Bosnian Serb troops, despite a NATO airstrike today to protect the city. Later on Nightline, will baseball fans ever forgive the national pastime? That's News Brief.
Okay, watch closely. This is the new DQ Treatza Pizza, but it's not a hot eat. It's a cool treat, a treat you eat like pizza. There's fudge, chocolate crunch, soft serve, and your choice of four different combinations of toppings, all for just $4.99. New frozen DQ Treatza Pizza, the only pizza that tastes better cold.
Hot eats, cool treats, we treat you right.
Something big is going down at your Ford dealer. So big, it happens only once a year. It's Ford's factory authorized clearance. Inventory has been moved into position. Special price stickers have been posted, all in anticipation of the biggest sales event of the year. You get low financing or up to $2,000 cash back on Ford Taurus. Everything is clearance price to move. It's back, and it's big. Ford's factory authorized clearance at your Central Kentucky Ford dealer. Be there.
University of Kentucky Healthcare is known for its state-of-the-art facilities, some of America's leading physicians, and doctors who practice what they teach. But it all starts with primary care for you and your family. And whether you need a simple checkup or highly specialized care, we do it all. UK Healthcare. Why turn to anyone else?
Try Rally's new XL combos. For only 39 cents more, get a big 32-ounce drink, large fries, and your favorite Rally sandwich. Just order.
Big Buford XL combo, please.
Chicken sandwich XL combo. Rally burger XL combo, please.
And when you get your XL combo, be sure to play Rally's Always Good, Always Fast sweepstakes. Just peel the game sticker off your drink cup, and you could win a Mustang convertible or one of 2.5 million other prizes. Only at Rally's. Twice as good, twice as fast.
Sky Ansi, weeknights on News Channel 36.
Seven no-hitters are the most in baseball history. An eight-time All-Star. He's eligible for the Baseball Hall of Fame in 1999. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to Arlington tonight's American League honorary captain, baseball's all-time strikeout king, Nolan Ryan.
Nolan Ryan, moments ago, throwing out the ceremonial first pitch. 27 seasons in the majors. It was in the dirt, low and away, but he still got it up there at about 85 miles an hour. At the age of 48, the great Nolan Ryan. And on the subject of guys who can bring it up there in a hurry, Randy Johnson, at the top of his game the other night in Cleveland, he pitched a complete game against the Indians in which he struck out 13 and didn't walk a batter. It's the first time in his career he pitched a complete game without issuing a walk. So Randy Johnson will get the start tonight. It was between Randy and Kevin Apier. And Johnson's been the hotter of the two lately, and that made the difference. 2 years ago, you'll recall, in Baltimore, John Kruk of the Philadelphia Phillies, then of the Phillies, now of the White Sox, stepped to the plate, lefty against lefty. He had not seen Randy Johnson, and you'll recall the moment. Over his head, the heart palpitations, and you know what happened in the rest of that at-bat. Kruk kept bailing out, and Johnson wound up with a strikeout.
Well, I think...
So Randy Johnson will go to the mound, and if you've just picked us up, the lineups were introduced about 15 minutes ago, so we'll bring them back for you. Dykstra, Gwynn, and Bonds for the National League, followed by Piazza in the cleanup spot, then McGriff and Gant, the designated hitter, Larkin, Castilla, and Biggio. The National League starting lineup brought to you by Budweiser. Defensively now for the American League, Albert Bell and Kenny Lofton of the Indians in left and center, and Kirby Puckett in right. The infield, Wade Boggs makes his 10th straight start at third. Cal Ripken, his 12th straight All-Star start at shortstop. So they have made each other's acquaintance in mid-July for over a decade. Baerga is at second, Thomas at first, with Ivan Pudge Rodriguez back of the plate and Randy Johnson on the mound. He'll be followed probably by Apier, then we'll see Dennis Martinez, and then some of the closers on the staff. Cal Ripken, of course, the centerpiece this year. As we look ahead to September, if he stays healthy, he will on September 6th, barring a rainout between now and then, eclipse the mark that everybody thought was unattainable, Lou Gehrig's consecutive game mark. The umpires tonight, Durwood Merrill of the American League is back of the plate. Charlie Williams of the National at first. Al Clark, American at second. Mike Winters, National at third. Ted Hendry of the American League down the line in left. And Ed Rapuano down the line in right. There are some different rules in effect. The starters, except pitchers, have to play at least three innings unless they're hurt. The pitcher is limited to three innings, except if the game goes beyond nine. The DH is in effect in the American League park. Starting pitcher doesn't have to pitch five to win. And a catcher can come back. You can start the game, and then if the other catcher gets hurt, you can re-enter the game. And the three knockdown rule is not in effect. Oh. We are ready. Lenny Dykstra to lead off of the Philadelphia Phillies. Some guys earn their way into the game by virtue of what they've done during the course of a season, others via reputation. Lenny is the first to admit it's the latter case here as he comes in hitting just 262.
And a reminder that Lenny Dykstra is the center fielder for the defending National League champion Philadelphia Phillies because of the strike last year.
Randy Johnson starts him with a fastball, missing ball one. And among other things, with Johnson facing the American League, they're going to take the first ball and throw it out of the game right now, and I guess send it to Cooperstown or to the Texas Hall of Fame or someplace, and that's the reason for the momentary delay. But Johnson gets to face four left-handed batters among the first five hitters.
And in the American League, only facing 29 all year long, they're 3-for-29 with 18 strikeouts.
Three harmless singles by left-handers off Johnson this year.
Kruk revisited in a way, and the count is 2-0.
Well, if you're a former pitcher, I mean, this is like a perfect time to pitch. Twilight, of course, you like to throw the ball over. But if you're a hitter, I'm not sure you can really pick the ball up that well.
That's all Johnson needs, another advantage.
The 2-0 is in there, and the count is 2-1. You're right, Jimmy, he has everything going for him right now. Mm-hmm. Dykstra's never seen him. Lefty against lefty, and in the dusk.
I'm sure Lenny's very happy that he hasn't seen Randy Johnson before.
2-2 the count. Dykstra, then Tony Gwynn and Barry Bonds in the first inning.
About the only thing I think, Al, that he doesn't have going for him is that he threw 160 pitches in that last start against Cleveland. And he's been pitching on a, contrary to what most major league pitchers pitch now, which is 4 days rest, only three. And only, remember, will only probably go two or three innings the most.
Dykstra, bothered by a bad back and has missed a lot of time this year, takes up high, ball three, 3-2. Lenny's 262 averaged the lowest among the 18 players in the starting lineups. And through the shadows, it's up high for ball four. It figures Randy Johnson comes off a game in which he did something he'd never done. Went all the way, doesn't issue a walk, comes to the All-Star game, walks the first hitter.
Well, I think one of his problems when he first came up was walks, almost seven walks per game. Now he's got it down before this ball game to just under three. And of course, if you're tall and you're pumped up and you're 6'10", you're all arms and legs, you have a tendency to overthrow.
Tony Gwynn lifts one in the air down the left field line, and moving over is Albert Bell to make the catch. So one pitch and Gwynn is gone, and Dykstra gets back to first with Barry Bonds coming up.
Tony Gwynn quoted in the paper today here in Dallas saying that the best thing to do about Randy Johnson as far as your hitting is concerned is to take him the other way and then sit down. And that's what he did.
Mm-hmm. Real quickly, go yeah. after that first pitch. I mean, yeah. why string it out? Barry Bonds making his fourth consecutive All-Star start. Three more starts than his father had, but Bobby was an All-Star Game MVP. Dad won it in 1-0 the count. Dykstra at first base and one out in the first inning in the first All-Star game ever played in what's known as the Metroplex. The area between Dallas and Fort Worth, Arlington about halfway between the two cities, and a ballpark that opened up last season. And Johnson misses away, 3-0 the count.
Randy Johnson with a history of control problems, so I'm sure he's glad that Durwood Merrill is the umpire tonight.
I would think so. I mean, of all the umpires in the American League, most of them down on one knee, Durwood umpires right over the top. A little more ample strike zone than most. You could kind of see his arms, and I mean, I've pitched to him many, many years. That's where he wants you to throw it, right between those arms. And of course, Randy Johnson have a little problem doing that.
Dykstra at first, held on by Thomas, and he goes, and Bond swings and misses, and Rodriguez guns him down. And the crowd loves that. Bud Rodriguez of the Rangers gunning down Dykstra.
And Pudge really having a difficult time throwing for the last 3 weeks. Dykstra does not have a good jump. Johnson delivers the ball in a hurry. I mean, Rodriguez with a gun for an arm nails Dykstra at second. 13 of the last 14 that have tried have stolen against Rodriguez.
And now Bonds strikes out swinging. So they go from a man on and 3-0 on Bonds to, in effect, three up and three down. And the National League doesn't score in the first.
If you could listen to what people really want and design a car around that. If you could give them the comfort they want and the safety features they need and build it to quality standards you've never met before, you'd have a pretty good car. But if you could do all this starting at $16,300, you'd have a genuine Chevrolet. Introducing the all-new 1995 Chevy Lumina.
Pizza Hut Lunch Buffet. You can get all the pizza, pasta, and salad you can eat for just $3.99.
What's $3.99 times 50,000?
$200,000.
How much you got on you?
About $100,000. I got two.
I got a quarter mil.
Yeah, you got change?
How do you know? Who do you trust? What do they really say? Only one long-distance company gives you written proof that your business saves over AT&T. There's no question about savings with MCI's Proof Positive.
Sure, my business is saving with AT&T. At least I think so. I feel that we are. I'm sure that we are. How would I know if we weren't? I don't think we'd know. I don't know if we're saving.
There's no question about savings with MCI's Proof Positive.
First it was OJ, then it was Hugh Thursday. Could it be Matlock?
Ben Matlock caught an alien love triangle.
A scandalous Matlock Thursday on ABC.
Quite a sight on the prairie. The ballpark in Arlington, and quite a sight on the mound. Who would have figured? Hideo Nomo, last year pitching in Japan. had five no decisions, then went 6-0 in June, and they had a lot of the youth baseball players from the area as a part of the pregame ceremonies tonight, and there they were all greeted by Nomo. Again, the American League batting order brought to you by Budweiser, Lofton, Baerga, and Edgar Martinez, then Thomas, Bell, and Ripken, Boggs, Puckett, and Rodriguez. Bonds, Dykstra, and Gwynn in the National League outfield. Castilla at third, Larkin at short, Biggio at second, McGriff at first, Piazza catching, and Hideo Nomo with Lofton at the plate, missing up high, ball one. If you haven't seen Nomo, he has an irregular motion, to say the least. He's got a little bit of Louis Tiant. He's got a little bit of Juan Marichal and a few other guys as well. But a great fastball and a great forkball, and the fastball is ripped down the line and right and just fouled.
Well, Kenny Lofton, this is his fourth year. He came up, did not hit a home run his first year. The second year, a little about seven. Last year, 12, as you watch Nomo's windup, but he's become a much better hitter.
And that's in there for a strike.
Well, that's the pitch that he gets most of the strikeouts on, and that's the splitter. He'll throw two of them, one for a strike, and when he gets ahead, that's the one he throws a little bit out of the strike zone.
Now the 1-2 pitch to Lofton.
Here it is.
Waved at and missed. And boy, I tell you, you've got the forkball here, and you've also got the twilight, and you've got a strip of sunlight between the mound and the plate. The All-Star Game is being brought to you by Chevrolet, the cars and trucks 36 million people depend on every day, genuine Chevrolet. By MCI, the company that brings you proof positive. And by Beechwood Aged Budweiser, the king of beers, this bud's for you. Carlos Baerga, the switch-hitting Cleveland Indians second baseman, one of six Indians on the American League All-Star team. And we can get a shot of how difficult it is. There's Nomo in the shade through the strip of sunlight and to the speckled home plate area.
Even though we're out here in Arlington, Texas, it reminds you a little of Yankee Stadium.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of shadows, dappled light.
Pop foul, and not a lot of room in foul territory in this park. 1-1 the count.
I tried to talk to as many National League hitters about Nomo. I said, "What, you know, what makes him so difficult?" Well, he throws 90 miles per hour. He's got the great split ball, occasional curveball. Bobby Bonilla said, "You've never seen anything like it." I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "The windup, so unusual, hides the ball so well."
Waved at and stroked into right field for a base hit. So Baerga picks up the game's first hit, a single to right, and Carlos is on with one out and Edgar Martinez coming up.
Not too many better hitters around than Carlos Baerga, and he's the type of hitter that would probably handle Nomo better because Baerga has such great plate coverage and is an excellent bad ball hitter. That pitch right around the ankles, and he golfed it to right.
Here is a guy whose nickname should be the Great Unknown. Edgar Martinez leads the league in hitting. He's already won a batting championship. And he is as anonymous a star as there is in the game today. And part of the reason, of course, is he's played on teams that really haven't contended in the past. He plays in Seattle, not a big media center. And he's on a team that possesses two genuine superstars in Ken Griffey Jr. and Randy Johnson. So just wind them up, and this guy hits 350, and nobody knows about it. In there, 1-1.
Well, I'll tell you, there are a lot of American League pitchers that know about Edgar Martinez. In 92, won the batting championship. The next year, hurt his hamstring. Last year, opening day, hamstring was fine. Dennis Martinez plunked him, bothered by a wrist. But singles to right when he gets ahead in the count. Maybe the pitcher falls behind. He becomes a home run hitter.
Baerga with a very short lead at first. And Martinez fouls it back on the count, 1-2. Martinez leading the league in hitting at 363. Chili Davis is still on the disabled list, 4 points back. O'Neill is here. O'Leary is not, and neither is Nearing. So only two of the top five on the American League All-Star team.
When you get a little older, you have to cut down on the weight of your bat, and that's what Martinez has done, an ounce and a half lighter.
Baerga goes, the pitch is high, and Piazza's throw is one hop and a great tag made by Biggio. So there's the catcher throwing to a former catcher, scooped out by Biggio at second, who makes the tag on Baerga sliding in. And each catcher has thrown out a runner here in the first inning.
Well, from his catcher's training, Biggio shows you how to handle balls in the dirt. He did it for years as a catcher, and now he does it as a second baseman. Fine play by Biggio.
3-2 now on Martinez.
And the amazing thing about that is that, as good as Nomo's been, they have been successful stealing 14 out of 16. So that's only the third time all year long they've caught a runner.
And down goes Martinez. So the first inning for each side mirrors each other's. And at the end of one, no score.
There's a fine line of motor oil separating your car's engine parts that's as little as a thousandth of an inch. But friction and heat can make motor oil become volatile and vaporize, weakening its ability to protect expensive parts. Texaco Haviland Formula 3 is formulated to control volatility, fight vaporization, and provide complete engine protection, no matter what you drive.
Add more life to your car.
Take it to the star.
Like all Americans, I like big things. Big prairies. Big forests and mountains. Big wheat fields. And everything else.
Sir, what's it like living at the typical mid-priced business hotel?
It's okay if you're big on self-denial.
Because you deserve better, ITT Sheraton introduces Four Points Hotels.
They live for the pleasure, the passion, the thrill. Now they will live forever. Tom Cruise, Brad Pitt, Interview with the Vampire, rated R.
Meet the world's most courageous and inspirational athletes at the Special Olympics World Games. Plus, more racing from the Tour de France, Saturday on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Hideo Nomo does not speak very good English, but when he first got to the Dodger training camp this spring, the first words he learned, "Hey, dude." So he had a lot of dudes shaking his hand, giving him the high five.
It's a high five in any language, and Mike Piazza, his battery mate, to lead off in the second inning. No score. Piazza, Fred McGriff, and then Ron Gant. Mike hitting .377, and in his third year in the league, playing in his third All-Star game, and Tommy Lasorda was telling the L.A. media, along with Fred Clair, just put his name down with a lot of carbon paper. He's going to be on the All-Star team year after year after year. And barring injury, he will. Great player.
And we talked about Nomo high five for pitching. This guy gets a high five for hitting. We're not talking about Ivan Rodriguez, even though he's hitting well over .330. But I mean, Piazza, boom, right in the dome. Timmy, you took a few of those off your mask.
Yes, I did. I'm glad you said mask.
Randy Johnson. The 1-2 pitch is grounded to the right side and backhanded by Thomas, who flips to Johnson covering for the out. One up, one down. John Saunders is working the American League dugout tonight. Let's check in with John.
All right, Al, thanks a lot. Here with Ken Griffey Jr., who would be starting in this game for a sixth straight time as an All-Star. He must miss being out there, not having a chance to start.
Well, yeah, I miss it, but, you know, the fans voted me in, and I'm just here to show my support to the game I love and for all the people who punched my name out.
Give us an update on the broken wrist. I understand a plate and some screws in it.
I've got six screws and a plate, but it's not as bad as everybody thinks it is, but it is. It's tough. Rehab's a little slow, only because of stiffness. I'm trying to work the flexibility right now, and then I go into strength. But once I get my flexibility, which they said would be 100%, I'll be back to strengthen it after that, then I start playing.
When do you think you'll be back?
They say mid-August, early September.
All right. Congratulations on being an All-Star again, and get back as quick as you can. Right now, back up to Al.
All right, thank you, John. As Fred McGriff stands in with one out on the bases empty and no score. Ken Griffey, a former All-Star Game MVP, an award won last year by McGriff. And the count now on Fred is 1-2. Fred hit a home run to tie last year's game in Pittsburgh in the ninth inning. Subsequently, one in the tenth on a Moises Alou double. Fred McGriff, who ended the first half of the season on Sunday night with a three-run ninth-inning homer to beat the Giants, and he goes down on strikes, and that's two strikeouts for Randy Johnson.
The one thing that left-handers cannot do is keep that right hip in against Randy Johnson. See the hip fly open. Once the hip goes, an outside slider, you can forget about it.
You just talk about plate coverage, and once you recognize that, and again, you know, Johnson throws so hard, you think that the fastball is his best pitch, but I honestly believe the slider is the best pitch because you just can't pick it up.
Ron Gant of the Cincinnati Reds with a count 1-0. Gant, one of two Reds in the lineup. Gant, normally an outfielder, but with the All-Star game played in the American League Park, you have a designated hitter, and he is the DH in there. 1-1. Gant, a remarkable comeback. Broke his leg after signing a huge contract with Atlanta in a motorcycle accident in February of 94. Swing and a miss. And then Atlanta released him, and the Reds took a chance on him, and it has really paid off.
Now, this is what you face if you're the hitter. I mean, this is the look. Not a whole lot of time. Probably about 0.2 seconds to make up your mind.
2-2.
That last fastball that he threw by Gant, 96 miles an hour. And of course, he releases it a little farther out in front of him than most guys. He's 6'8".
Actually, Timmy, make it 6'10". It's worse than you thought if you're a hitter.
3-2 the count.
Talked about the control problems. Had a talk with Nolan Ryan down here and his pitching coach, Tom House.
And Gant goes down on strike. So Randy Johnson in two innings, strikes out three, faces the minimum six. No score at the end of an inning and a half.
Communication services at your mid-priced business hotel.
Sometimes you get through, sometimes you don't.
Because you deserve better communications, ITT Sheraton introduces Four Points Hotels.
Here at Goodyear's biggest tire plant, we're gearing up for the tire sale you've been waiting for. It's our 25% off sale. Save 25% on selected Goodyear tires at participating retailers all across America. But hurry, this sale ends July 22nd.
At Chevrolet, we feel everyone, regardless of income, deserves a safe car. That's why we equip the all-new Lumina LS with dual airbags, anti-lock brakes, side guard door beams, child security rear door locks. Sure, anyone can build a car like this. That's easy. We build it so most people can afford it. That's genuine Chevrolet.
Waco, 2 years later, a tough new look. Diane Sawyer's exclusive interviews with the ATF agents who were there, under fire. What really happened? Turning Point, Thursday.
The ballpark in Arlington, Texas, site of the All-Star game, bottom of the second inning, no score. Hideo Nomo of the Dodgers working on Frank Thomas, Albert Bell, and Cal Ripken. Frank Thomas, who won the home run derby here yesterday, takes inside. The longest shot he hit yesterday afternoon, 470 feet. Thomas 3-for-3 in his prior All-Star game appearances. A swing and a miss, 1-1.
Well, one of his great strengths is the idea of knowing exactly what's the strike and what's the ball. Leads the American League in most walks with 70. You don't see this too often. Nomo usually throwing around 90, throws it right by him at 93 miles per hour. I guess he's pumped too.
2-1. But this is the essence of the All-Star game. Forget National League against American League. Oh, there's a minimal rooting interest, but it's confrontations like this. How would Nomo do against Thomas? A mile high pop. That's as high as it gets. Piazza.
Whoops.
Two down.
Whoops. Snow cone.
You cannot hit a ball any higher than Frank Thomas just hit that pop-up.
Well, here's the pitch selection, Hideo Nomo. Really only three pitches. In fact, the two main ones we put. You saw the splitter, and now you see the four-seam fastball. National League hitters may be 10 slow curveballs. Some pitch the other night didn't throw one. Well, you ask about the confrontation. Got behind two balls and one strike to maybe the best hitter in the American League. Got him to pop up. Pretty impressive.
Now Albert Bell hitting 312. And it's pretty clear at this point in the season that the Indians are the best team in baseball. A huge lead in the American League Central Division. They are 12 games in front. They're 46-21. Six Indians have made the All-Star team. And Albert Bell having a spectacular year again. In the dirt, 1-1.
First time that three Indians as position players have started an All-Star game since 1952. Bobby Avila was the second baseman, Al Rosen the third baseman, and Dale Mitchell played left field.
Dale Mitchell, forever known, of course, as the guy who struck out against Don Larsen to end Larsen's perfect game in the 56 World Series.
On a pitch that was outside.
Yes, sir. In the bullpen for the American League, Kevin Apier, who is the winningest pitcher in the majors, will pitch the third inning. Randy Johnson is done after two, giving up no hits and no runs and striking out three. The 2-1 pitch is fouled back, and the count 2-2 on Bell with Ripken on deck. Randy Johnson with three strikeouts in two innings, so that's an average of 13.5 per nine. Nolan Ryan with a single season record, but as you see, Johnson's on a pace to eclipse it, and so is Nomo this season. Fouled away, and the count remains 2-2.
Well, the honorary captain for the American League, Nolan Ryan, we saw him throw out the first pitch. How about 5,714 lifetime strikeouts?
1,700 ahead of his nearest opponent, Steve Carlton.
He should be.
Yeah. 1,700 ahead. You talk about records that may never be broken.
And down goes Bell. And that's a good segue, Tim, because of all the records that nobody figured would ever be broken, the guy coming up next is the one guy who's on his way to breaking it. 2,130 consecutive games for Lou Gehrig. But Ripken's going to get there if he can stay healthy between now and early September.
Well, here you are. Five American League hitters, three down on strikes. They were looking for the fork ball. He threw the express right by him.
Cal Ripken makes his 12th consecutive All-Star game start. One and oh.
Actually, the 12th straight year, and that is a record. Willie Mays had 14 All-Star game starts, but that was when two a year were played from 59 through 62.
Ripken lashes one to right field, and on the run is Tony Gwynn to make the catch. So it's a three-up, 3-down inning with some help from Gwynn. Nomo sets the American League down in order. We'll go to the third at Arlington. As we go to commercial, we'll look at Gwynn's catch. No score.
I've been living with heartburn and acid indigestion for 30 years. How's that going to help?
It's new, Mom. It's Pepcid AC Acid Controller. It's not an antacid.
It's different. Read the box.
Pepcid AC.
Look, I've taken prescription Pepcid. My doctor said
it's now in non-prescription strength for heartburn.
It's a little pill.
Mm-hmm. That little Pepcid AC pill relieves the heartburn and then controls acid for 9 hours.
9 hours?
And there's something else. Pepcid AC can even prevent heartburn from happening.
Pepcid AC can do that, and acids can't claim that.
So?
So I'd say I can have pizza again.
Oh, I already ordered it.
Oh.
You can be heartburn free with new Pepcid AC. Tylenol Extended Relief.
They named it Tylenol Extended Relief because it's extended relief.
I can't give it a better name than Tylenol Extended Relief because that's what it does.
Remember, it's Tylenol Extended Relief.
Perfect name, great product.
How close are you to all the sports you'd ever want to see with Primestar? Closer than you think. Primestar has all the action you're looking for, plus lots of other great programming, all with digital picture and sound. And since Primestar is a service, there's no equipment to buy. And it all starts at about $1 a day. So if you love sports, call 1-800-PRIMESTAR.
Somewhere men are laughing. And somewhere children shout. But there is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out.
And he hits it high deep. And you can forget about it.
Maybe they should have traded him for Bonds.
A three-run tater for Barry Bonds.
Get ready for the summer's hottest hit. The Indians, the Braves, the Red Sox, and the Reds are all in the season premiere of Baseball Night in America, Saturday on ABC.
No score. Randy Johnson has set down the National League through two innings, and Kevin Apier of the Kansas City Royals comes in making his first All-Star game appearance. Apier is the youngest pitcher on the American League staff at age 27. The book says Jose Mesa of Cleveland is 29, but it could be that Apier is the only pitcher on the staff in his 20s. Could be. And he will face Larkin, Castilla, and Biggio. The Goodyear blimp, stars and stripes hovering, bright blue Texas sky, not a cloud in the sky. The temperature close to 100 degrees at game time. The ballpark in Arlington, home of the Rangers, who at the break in the American League West Division are tied for first place with the California Angels, 9 games above .500. Barry Larkin getting the start because Ozzie Smith was hurt. He gets the start, and Vinny Castilla starts at third with Matt Williams hurt. And earlier we talked about Griffey and the fact he was injured, and Kenny Lofton getting the start in center field for the American League. So three replacement starters. As Larkin takes the first pitch, low, ball one, 1-0. And there is Ozzie Smith. As Larkin takes up high, but Larkin now with Ozzie approaching retirement, you know, Barry finally getting his due. He's been a terrific player for a lot of years.
Won his first Gold Glove last year. Got an interesting term, replacement starters. About four months ago, that's what baseball thought that they may have to use here in Texas, replacement starters.
Timmy, that's a dreadful thought.
We thought we'd do this game with your plumber hitting cleanup.
Instead of Bill Plumber.
Right. Yeah, huh?
Where is Bill Plumber?
I'm sure we'll hear tomorrow. 2-1 pitch is hit in the air down the line in right field, and not a lot of room in foul territory, and it drifts back out of play. Two balls and two strikes to count. Strikeout leaders in the American League. Well, Johnson on top with 152. And he struck out three tonight. Apier would be next. Todd Stottlemyre of Oakland in triple figures. Finley is here. David Cohn won the Cy Young Award last year, but is not here.
No, Apier also leading in most starts, has been pitching on a 4-day rotation. The only pitcher that's been doing that, in fact, the whole new staff in Kansas City all year long. But that's that slider, and he is a control pitcher. I mean, the league is hitting under 200 at 198, which is the lowest in the American League, or at least the lowest of the pitchers here at the All-Star game.
Three balls, two strikes on Larkin, leading off in the third inning with no score. He reaches out, grounds it down to Baerga, and the Indian second baseman throws him out. One away, Castilla coming up, and let's check in. We'll go to the National League dugout and Leslie Visser. Leslie?
Al, in Japanese, his name means hero, and that's what his teammates have thought of him so far, Hideo Nomo and his interpreter, Kent Brown. Hideo, what was the experience of being out there and with your teammates, and was this much more than you expected when you signed with the Dodgers?
Not only tonight, but last night, it's been a wonderful experience.
Quite a special experience. Well, you worked, people have said that you're reminiscent of Louis Tian. In fact, you worked with him in spring training. What was the biggest adjustment for you both on and off the field?
Louis Tian の選手と一緒に練習しましてですね。そしたらね、一番大きな怖いことは何でしょうか？
怖いこと？
投げり方に。
え？投げることで？
投球すること。
No change at all. It's the same as always.
It is. Well, pretty impressive. He says it's just this hot in Osaka, Al.
Well, he did what the crowd came to see him do tonight, as Vinny Castilla is at the plate, 0-2 the count, and he waves at it and goes down swinging. So the Colorado Rockies' Vinny Castilla strikes out for the second out here in the third inning, and that will bring up Craig Biggio.
Well, this is a pitcher's pitch. You get ahead in the strike zone. I mean, you can see Rodriguez move out, and that's that good, hard slider that he throws. Also has a splitter very much like Hideo Nomo. It's like he traded a baseball for one of her front teeth. Pretty good trade.
Tough to leave under a pillow, isn't it?
That ball's worth a heck of a lot more now than it was earlier today. 1-0 the count on Craig Biggio. You think of the Astros through the years, and they've had a fair amount of success, and yet Houston has not had a non-pitcher start an All-Star game since 1973. It'd be 22 years. The last non-pitcher to start would be Cesar Cedeno in the 73 All-Star game. And here's Biggio, who began his career back of the plate and then won a gold glove at second base. Wrapping one down to short. And Ripken throws him out. So it's a 1-2-3 inning for Apier. The pitcher's dominant early. No score after 2.5.
Nothing is tougher on dirt. Than a 191 horsepower Chevy S-Series extended cab 4x4. Chevy trucks like a rock.
Time marches on, and if you haven't planned for your retirement, you're losing ground. If you're like most Americans, you probably haven't saved enough, long enough, to retire on solid ground. That's why there's SunAmerica. Ask your financial advisor about SunAmerica today, because the only thing that goes faster than money is time. Look to the sun, SunAmerica.
A U.S. satellite with a nuclear payload is missing.
It's like somebody just took it.
Global disaster is imminent.
This I'm trained for.
Steven Seagal, Under Siege 2, Dark Territory, rated R, starts Friday, July 14th.
Sir, what's room service like at your mid-priced business hotel?
They let you call out for pizza.
Because you deserve room service, ITT Sheraton introduces Four Points Hotels.
For cars that can benefit from higher octane...
Frank, we're late.
Texaco Clean System 3 Power Plus and Power Premium are formulated to clean your engine's intake valves, fuel injectors, and combustion chambers while you're driving for smooth starts and sure acceleration. Just give us 5 tanks, and we think you'll see a difference. A word of advice, though. Maybe you'd better leave the windows rolled up.
Thursday, it's an all-new McKenna, where the adventure's as big as all outdoors. From race cars to romance, you'll find what you're looking for on McKenna, Thursday on ABC.
No score as we go to the bottom of the third inning at the ballpark in Arlington. It has that, as you can see, that old brick facade around the circumference of the stadium, and it's fully enclosed, and in center field is a four-story office building. I was reading a story, one of the architects was talking about the fact they wanted to enclose it because when you looked out, you didn't see downtown high rises as you do in Baltimore or Cleveland. All you see, as he put it, were a whole bunch of industrial sheds and dry prairie land for miles. So they enclosed it. They put you in here. It's like being in a time warp, and it's like being in a geography warp as well. As John Smiley delivers the first pitch to Boggs, and he hits one to center field, and Dykstra is there to make the catch. So one out, Puckett coming up, and let's check in with former Oriole catcher Rick Dempsey in the bullpen. Rick?
Thank you, Al. I go back a long way with this guy right here. I had him when he was a pup, his first day in the big leagues. He was a great pitcher back in the Baltimore Orioles organization, but I think he gets better and better every year now, pitching in your fourth All-Star game. 40 years old. How do you feel, Dennis?
Well, Rick, it's like you say, it's been way back when we started this thing, but now I'm feel proud that I'm still here playing, and I feel proud to be in my fourth All-Star game, representing the Cleveland Indians this time in my hometown. Nicaragua.
Okay, Al, back up to you.
All right, thank you, Rick. Rick Dempsey doing double duty, working with us tonight. He's also the manager of the Dodgers AAA Farm Club in Albuquerque. And the pitch inside to Kirby Puckett, and the count, 2 balls and no strikes.
Matter of fact, he told his ball club in Albuquerque that he would shave his head if they won 10 in a row. So they have won 10 in a row, and he is going to get a buzz cut.
Puckett hits one right back to the mound. And Smiley throws him out with Ivan Rodriguez coming up. A reminder coming up Saturday. First of 6 games on ABC, Baseball Night in America. Regional games around the country. Check your local listings beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern and 7 Central. The crowd loves it now because Ivan Rodriguez, their guy, comes up to hit. One of 2 Rangers on the All-Star team. The other is the pitcher Kenny Rogers. So Pudge Rodriguez, who has established himself clearly as the best catcher in the league, stands in with 2 out and the bases empty in the third. And Smiley nips the corner for a strike.
Rodriguez's 4th All-Star game, and he's only 23 years old.
And how about having to face a lineup if you're the opposition, the opposing pitcher, the ninth hitter is hitting .332.
A lot of that credit, says Rodriguez, goes to Rudy Jaramillo, who was formerly the batting instructor down for the Houston Astros and very instrumental in Jeff Bagwell's season last year. MVP was Bagwell.
That's grounded down to short. Barry Larkin scoops it up, throws him out. 3 quick innings in the books. No score. We'll go to the fourth after this from our ABC stations.
It's 2 of your favorite stars together for the first time. Tony Danza's back on television with Lori Loughlin in Hudson Street, coming this fall on ABC.
Okay, watch closely. This is the new DQ Treats a Pizza, but it's not a hot eat. It's a cool treat, a treat you eat like pizza. There's fudge, chocolate crunch, soft serve, and your choice of 4 different combinations of toppings, all for just $4.99. New frozen DQ Treats a Pizza. The only pizza that tastes better cold.
Hot eats, cool treats, we treat you right.
At Bank One, we're always bringing the latest financial services to our customers. Now we're about to do it again. Introducing Personal Investment Centers from Bank One Securities Corporation. Oh! The power of Wall Street located right inside your bank. Bank One, whatever it takes.
Something big is going down at your Ford dealer. So big, it happens only once a year. It's Ford's factory authorized clearance. Inventory has been moved into position. Special price stickers have been posted, all in anticipation of the biggest sales event of the year. You get low financing or up to $2,000 cash back on Ford Taurus. Everything is clearance price to move. It's back, and it's big. Ford's factory authorized clearance at your Central Kentucky Ford dealer. Be there.
The Apollo 13 movie, American Heroes, and we're bringing them back.
Hello, Hardee's. We are hungry. Over.
Roger. Apollo, recommend 3 Apollo combos. Over.
Roger.
2 juicy beef patties, cheese, and special sauce with booster-sized fries and Coke, just $2.99. Hardee's Apollo combo.
We are go for lunch.
The biggest combo for the money on the planet.
Think they'll be back?
The taste always brings them back.
Fresh from the kitchen at Hardee's. Over.
Collect all 20 Apollo 13 Pog Milk Caps and Moon Slammer, just 99 cents with any Hardee's combo.
Isaac Hayes and Lightfoot on the next Live.
Fourth inning, and there's an All-Star. 7 times he made the All-Star team. Larry Doby, he was the first black player in the American League. Jackie Robinson, of course, preceded him in the National League, now an assistant to American League president Gene Buttig. 13-year career with Cleveland, Chicago, and Detroit. The great Larry Doby. He's looking on. A rapidly played 3 innings as Len Dykstra leads off in the 4th. Dykstra, Gwynn, and Barry Bonds to face Kevin Apier, the National League without a hit. Lenny Dykstra walked his first time up and was thrown out stealing. Started his career with the Mets and then went to the Phillies in 89. And what a deal that turned out to be. You might say that the Mets were hornswoggled. Trying to get in a local term in that trade. Disastrous deal for New York, and it turned out to be a terrific trade for Philadelphia as he bounces one down to Baerga and he throws him out.
Lenny Dykstra and Roger McDowell for Juan Samuel. That was when Davey Johnson was the manager of the Mets, of course. Frank Cashin, the general manager. And then after the season was over, Juan Samuel moved out to Los Angeles, so the Mets had nothing after a half a season. Got rid of Dykstra and McDowell. So I think hornswoggled is the appropriate word.
It was. Here's Tony Gwynn taking a strike in the count 0-1.
Well, I guess if you're a Met fan, you got to be a little happy. Samuel is having a good year in Detroit this summer. It's just a little bit late.
Yeah.
Yeah, like 7 years late.
Exactly.
Right.
No problem outside of that. Mike Winter says that's a strike on the appeal, and the count is 0-2.
Tony Gwynn, 5 batting titles. A .335 career average for Tony Gwynn.
And that's inside, and the count 1-2.
In 120 years of National League history, only 3 players have won more batting titles than Tony Gwynn. Honus Wagner had 8. Rogers Hornsby had 7. Stan Musial, 7. Tony Gwynn, by the way, passed Wade Boggs this last week. Wade Boggs is now at .334 lifetime.
Mm-hmm. Highest average among all active players. One-two pitch. Broken bat bouncer gloved by Thomas, who thinks about flipping it to Apier and then does it himself. Well, you know, there's been so much talk about games and how long they are and the new rules that will be eventually instituted to speed them up. Here we are in the 4th inning with 2 out, and this game is about 45 minutes old. About as fast as it gets. Mm-hmm. There is a rookie, 1 of 3. Tyler Green, 1 of 3 on the staff. We already saw Nomo, Green of the Phillies, and Carlos Perez of the Expos, all rookie pitchers. As Bonds hits it weakly back to Apier in the National League through 4 innings, does not have a hit against Johnson and Apier. After 3.5 in Texas, no score.
American families have made their choice. Once again, they've chosen the Buick LeSabre as Family Circle Magazine's Family Car of the Year for reasons like safety, dependability, performance, and style. American families chose LeSabre as family car of the year over every other sedan, foreign or domestic. Buick LeSabre, the American family, family car.
On Friday, July 28th, Universal Pictures invites you to a world like none you've ever seen before. Kevin Costner. Waterworld, rated PG-13. Starts July 28th.
Sir, what's it like doing your own laundry at your mid-priced hotel?
I'm beginning to feel closer to my mother.
Because you deserve laundry service, ITT Sheraton introduces Four Points Hotels.
Here at Goodyear's biggest tire plant, we're gearing up for the tire sale you've been waiting for. It's our 25% off sale. Save 25% on selected Goodyear tires at participating retailers all across America. But hurry, this sale ends July 22nd.
Canadian drivers Jacques Villeneuve and Paul Tracy lead IndyCar's best north of the border. They hit the streets for the Molson Indy Toronto Sunday on ABC.
Bottom of the fourth inning in Arlington as the All-Star game continues. The American League and the National League scoreless. And the top of the order with Kenny Lofton to lead off, taking a strike. Each team has sent up the minimum number of players, though each team has had a base runner, the National League with a walk, the American League with a single, but each base runner was thrown out trying to steal. So nobody in this game has advanced past first base and the count 1-1. And it reflects what Tim talked about at the top. You think about the All-Star game and power displays and the great hitters, but the cumulative average of all of the All-Star games in history is 245. And Vigio goes to his knees, throws, and gets him. And that's a great play. Because Lofton is as quick as they come. The Indian center fielder and Vigio sprawled out and still able to get enough on his throw to get him at first.
Oh, just an outstanding play. I guess the irony here is that Vigio said before the game he gets changed from catcher to a second baseman after he makes the All-Star team. And then they need a catcher. So who they go out and trade for one. They go get Ed Taubensee. Mm-hmm. And who they give up? Mm-hmm. Kenny Lofton. So Lofton hits the ball. Biggio, who moves from behind the plate to second, robs him of a base hit here in the All-Star game.
And the ball slipped out of his hand as well, even better on the mm-hmm. replay.
And that's one of the reasons he was moved to second base, because of his athletic ability and his speed. Mm-hmm. They didn't want to squander that behind the plate.
Carlos Baerga has the only hit in the game. John Smiley, who was an addition to the pitching staff over the weekend, ahead now 0-2. Smiley made the staff only because Greg Maddux, who was named to the staff, suffered a slightly pulled groin in his last start for Atlanta last week. So Maddux, even though he is here, is not on the active roster, and Smiley takes his spot.
Well, he's got a great changeup, and he just threw it. There's Maddux with the glasses. Slocum.
0-2 the count.
It really appears, Tim, that he's come a long way talking about John Smiley. I saw him pitch with the Twins for a couple of years in the American League, but looking like he's using all his pitches, both sides of the plate.
Well, he fell into the habit of using that straight change, that circle change, too much. And now he's starting to throw right-handed hitters in particular inside. This is a changeup here, however.
And he lifts it into foul territory back of third, but so little room there. In Oakland, that's an out. In Texas, it's in the sixth row.
Tell you, Jim, if you pitch for 15 years, and you know this certainly better than I do, but if you pitch for 15 years in the major leagues, you have to, it's a constant series of adjustments that you have to make, and you have to adjust before the hitters adjust to you.
If you want to have a good year.
Yeah, right.
You really have to do it. The good ones, they adjust from hitter to hitter, as do hitters against pitchers.
Smiley's 0-2 pitch is grounded toward the hole, a base hit. So the only hits in the game belong to the Indians' Carlos Baerga. A single in the first to right, and a single to left here in the fourth, with Edgar Martinez coming up. And the All-Star game is being brought to you by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Remember Buick, the new symbol for quality in America. By Texaco, Clean System 3 gasolines. And by Nike, who encourages you to participate in the lives of America's youth. Look at that shot. I mean, that's just out in the middle of this prairie sits this ballpark. And as I said before, it's like it's a geography warp in the sense you have no idea when you're in this park that you're in Texas. It's a great stadium. It's a lot of fun when you look around and they have a lot of little nuances. But there's nothing really in it that's reflective of the Southwest, so to speak.
Except the weather.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I was expecting like a stucco exterior or something.
Hit down the line, foul. Well, you know, one of the reasons that teams like Cleveland and Baltimore clearly have been so successful in drawing people are the new parks. And even though they haven't drawn as well here as they have in those parks, you come into this stadium and just to come to the park, it's a treat. It really is. It's the kind of stadium you want to come early and stay very late. Come for batting practice and just enjoy it. They really did a beautiful job with this place. Martinez fouls it off and the count is 0-2.
Now you mentioned speed. Lofton with 19 steals, been thrown out 9 times. Alomar, we haven't seen him yet, with 11. Baerga with 5, only been caught 1. But the American League only stealing 63 bases, in the National League 144. I'm talking about these squads. So a lot more foot speed for the NL team tonight.
One out. Baerga at first, and Martinez pops it up into shallow left center field. Drifting out is Larkin to make the catch, and Baerga retreats to first. So Barry goes a long way to haul it in for the second out, and will bring up Frank Thomas.
Well, you talked about pitching inside. Look where this ball is. I mean, Martinez, we're talking about the top hitter. Can't get the bat out, gets up on the bat. And we talked earlier about Barry Larkin. Great instincts, because he does not catch that ball unless he immediately sprints out there, got under it, and made a nice catch.
He just opened his mouth in case Baerga does run. That means Biggio will be covering.
Of course, you know as well as I, Timmy, I don't think they want to take the bat out of this guy's hand.
No, I don't either. Not after yesterday.
Mm-mm. Frank Thomas, who has won back-to-back MVP awards, takes outside. He won it in the American League last year. And Tim, you mentioned Jeff Bagwell before, but it shows you from one year to the next what can happen. Bagwell, the National League MVP last year, not even on the All-Star team this season.
Interesting you mentioned Bagwell. He and Bagwell were born on the same day. Mm. Frank Thomas, born in Columbus, Georgia. Jeff Bagwell, born in Boston on the same day. And both of them win MVP awards for their respective leagues last year.
I talked about the great eye that Frank Thomas. I asked him, I said, you know, when did you learn the strike zone? He said, high school. He said, if I swung at bad pitches, I had a one-run wind sprint. Didn't want to do that.
Oh. Thomas drills one to deep left field. If it's fair, it's out of here by a mile, and it is fair. One of the things a crowd of 50,000 comes to see, the big hurt, putting the hurt on the National League.
How unusual is this? The first All-Star game played at Comiskey Park in 1933, and this is the first home run ever hit by a White Sox player.
It's amazing. Compositely, the White Sox in the All-Star game had 180 at-bats since 1933, and that's the first home run by a White Sox player.
Well, this is a missile launch. I mean, you think you're down on the east coast of Florida and they're launching one up into the skies. Well, that's what the America, I mean, you got to pitch around. That's the theme song.
Atlantis 2.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the amazing thing about the numbers that Thomas puts up is last year he had Darren Jackson hit behind him. He's in Japan. Julio Franco hit 20 home runs and 98 RBIs, hit well over 300. He's also in Japan. Well, he's the only guy in town over there.
Joe Kerrigan on the phone to the bullpen as Albert Bell lifts a pop-up back of third. Vinny Castilla calls for it, but Larkin says, I'll handle it, and Barry does. But the American League takes the lead on a two-run homer by Frank Thomas at the end of four. 2-0 Americans.
I believe hitting a round ball with a round bat is the hardest thing to do in all sports.
I believe Roberto Clemente is the patron saint of baseball.
I believe in the sacrifice fly.
I believe pitchers should buy catchers lunch.
I believe batting practice makes perfect.
I believe Lou Gehrig's birthday should be a national holiday.
I believe in the designated hitter.
I believe Tony Gwynn sleeps with his bat.
I believe the squeeze play should be taught in public schools.
I believe walls are hard.
No one's bigger than the game.
Except maybe Boo Powell.
I believe somebody, somewhere,
understands the infield fly rule.
I believe it's time to sing. Take me out to the ball game.
I believe even I sing better than Don Mattingly.
I believe that.
And I believe every player should have a day off after 2,160 games.
I believe dome stadiums are great.
For tractor pulls.
And I believe the two greatest words in the English language
are play ball.
Play ball.
Play ball.
Play ball.
I believe if Shoeless Joe Jackson was playing today, he'd have a shoe contract.
Gramercy Press in cyberspace. We can set up our own bookstore on the internet. Click the book they want right on the screen.
They're reading the baby.
We can go to the schools, textbooks direct to the children's little hands.
Cool.
Marketplace MCI, your new business address in cyberspace. Online, interactive, secure, at your fingertips. To install the 21st century in your office today, call 1-800-888-8100.
Let me guess. One side of you craves easy chair comfort, while the other side itches for performance, right? Well, meet Buick Regal, with its famous 3800 V6 engine and Grand Touring suspension. Add to that an all-new interior with body-sensitive seats. And finally, there's a car for the two of you. Buick Regal.
Is he crazy in love or just plain crazy?
Earl K. Long is the sanest man I've ever known.
All new men in Blaze, Sunday at a special time on ABC.
Two nothing, the American League on top on a two-run blast by Frank Thomas. And Thomas is done for the night. Mo Vaughn of the Boston Red Sox with his 24 home runs is the new first baseman, and the new pitcher is Jim Palmer's one-time teammate. I mean, a long time ago. 40-year-old Dennis Martinez having a brilliant season with Cleveland.
Well, he certainly is, and it's not always about power. I mean, we saw Nomo with the great fastball and the splitter, Johnson being overpowering. Dennis still throws awfully good for a guy 40. Great curveball, terrific changeup. And you talk about pitching, you got to work both sides of the plate. This guy can do it. But the bottom line, there's a guy that had a problem with alcohol. He battled it. He resurrected his life. And you're not going to find a better teammate to ever play with the exception of a guy that just got 3,000 hits. Mm-hmm. One of Dennis's teammates, Eddie Murray, than Dennis Martinez. Terrific guy and a great pitcher.
He faces Mike Piazza, Fred McGriff, and Ron Gant in the fifth inning. The National League still doesn't have a hit. The first batter of the game, Lenny Dykstra, drew a walk and was thrown out at second, attempting to steal. And since then, the National League has only hit one ball out of the infield. That was a fly ball to left by Gwynn in the first. 1-0 the count on Mike Piazza. Ripken's glove.
Oh.
Piazza gone, lining out to the shortstop. McGriff coming up, and let's get a word from John Saunders.
All right, Al, thanks a lot. Now, yesterday, Frank Thomas won the home run hitting contest. Nobody told you it was over?
No, not at all. We're down 0-0 there, and I just wanted to get some entertainment going in this ball game. I was going to take my hacks. This is where I face Nomo. I was going to swing hard at everything that's close. So, you know, I did that with John Smiley there, too. We're having fun, and that's what All-Star Game is all about, and I went out and had a little fun.
Jim Palmer said in our meetings yesterday that there is no one really who is in the type of zone that you are in. Is that the feeling you get each time you step to the plate?
Well, you know, the last couple of months, I normally get hot, so I'm swinging the bat well right now. Like I said, I'm just going out having a little more fun.
Unfortunately for the American League, he won't be able to stick around. He's got to catch a flight. They're playing tomorrow night, the day after the All-Star game, so we'll let you go. Congratulations, and you can hope your home run stands up.
Thank you very much, John. Have a great time.
All right, back to Al.
All right, McGriff launches one to right field, but Puckett is there on the warning track to make the catch for out number two here in the fifth inning. Well, there's baseball tomorrow, believe it or not. Three games are scheduled. There's also primetime on ABC tomorrow night featuring Home Improvement, Ellen, Grace Under Fire, Roseanne, and Primetime Live. That's the lineup. And then on Thursday, Matlock, McKenna, and a special episode of Day One with Diane Sawyer gracing your screen. That's Thursday right here on ABC. Ron Gant pops it up in foul territory, and Mo Vaughn is in foul ground to make the catch and retire the side. So Martinez has a 1-2-3 inning. The National League still doesn't have a hit as the American League leads 2-0.
So you're probably wondering how Oldsmobile ever came up with a car like this. Well, first we told all the bean counters to go to lunch. Then we sent all the pencil pushers home. And finally, we had our engineers watch a lot of exciting movies. The result wasn't like anything we'd ever done, or anyone else either. It's your money.
So much to reach for, and right now one company has the technology, the service, the experience. AT&T, creating vital bridges that help you put it all within your reach.
It's all within your reach.
That's your true choice. AT&T.
Senior Tour's biggest stars meet in Michigan hoping to drive away with one of their premier events. Coverage of the Ford Senior Players Championship begins Saturday on ABC Sports.
Sun going down over the Metroplex. That's what it's known, this area between Dallas and Fort Worth. Arlington, the site of the All-Star Game. Reggie Sanders comes in to play right field now, acknowledging somebody in the stands, and the new pitcher is the rookie from the Phillies, Tyler Green. So Tony Gwynn is done for the night. He flied out and grounded out. We have seen Nomo work two. We saw Smiley work two and give up a two-run homer to Frank Thomas, the only scoring in the game. And now Tyler Green, one of three rookies on the National League pitching staff, will go to work on Ripken, Boggs, and Puckett, the 6-7 and 8 hitters in the bottom of the fifth inning. Cal Ripken fly to right. His first time up, takes up high ball one. 1-0. Interesting that the American League was such a veteran staff. We talked about the fact that Apier and Mesa are the only ones listed under 30. And you've got three rookies here, and that's shot right back through the middle for a base hit. So Ripken with a single. Boggs coming up, and let's get a word from Leslie Visser.
Alan, with the man who passed Wade Boggs for career average, what does that mean to you, Tony Gwynn?
It means it was a long battle. I mean, this is about 10 years. You know, Wade was on fire early in his career, and, you know, he's still been consistent, but these last 3 years for me, I just can't explain it. I mean, I've hit the ball very well, and have, you know, this 10-year struggle to finally catch him is not something I really thought about, but when you come in here, everybody's telling you you caught him. You know, it's a nice feeling because he was a lifetime 340, 350 hitter for a long time, so to finally catch him and pass him, I guess, is something nice.
And what does it mean to have maybe a real pennant race with the Padres this year?
For me, it's like night and day. I mean, going